This is a great one.
Gilbert's here. I want to get him in. I don't like leaving him waiting around. He gets upset. Big star. There he is.
He was eyeing. I got him to eye the enormous free cupcakes.
Oh, I'm sure he took advantage of that. He loves free. Cooper's got a real short haircut now, almost like a Chinese guy.
Yeah, I'm doing Schindler's List, too.
Wow. You're almost completely bald.
Yeah.
Are you going bald?
No.
Why are you cutting your hair so short?
I don't know.
It's, you're lucky enough to have hair. Give it a little growth, no?
I guess I should. Kind of look like Robert Blake now.
Not really. It's like a... He looks Chinese.
A little bit. You know, you could put him in front of a rickshaw. It wouldn't look strange.
Do you go to a salon or do you go to like a barber shop?
Oh, barber shop.
Or do you get the Flobee and just do it?
Do you go to a barber shop because it's cheaper? It's the salons charge too much money?
Oh, sure.
Right.
Yeah.
No, you're very, very cheap, right?
Yeah, no, I don't go to any place that gives me a Perrier water when I walk
right.
in.
You don't need that.
Yeah. You don't want to pay extra for that.
So what's going on, man? When's the wedding? When is the baby due?
Oh, God, I try to block out all of that stuff.
He is so miserable. I would love to know how this all happened. Why did you ask her even to marry you? Because you knocked her up? What happened?
I don't know. I'm still expecting to wake up and have my old life back.
Why are you getting married exactly? Is it because you're having a kid, or is there other, like, romantic reasons?
Yeah, I have no idea. It's just too horrible.
Have you asked her to sign a prenuptial agreement?
I'm working on that, certainly.
Right. Yeah. It's hard, though, once you have the kid coming.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah.
But, Gilbert, is there a wedding being planned? Is there a date set?
I think so. I'm not involved in it.
Or yeah. I believe that.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
So how will you know to show up?
Yeah.
Is it hard to get you to come and look at centerpieces?
When is the baby due?
I think June.
June.
And is it a boy or a girl? Do you know yet?
No, I don't know yet.
I know. I interviewed the baby.
Yeah.
I went over with one of those, what do they call those?
Ultrasound?
Ultrasound machine, and lo and behold, we could actually converse.
You could hear the baby.
The baby said a few things to me that were rather intuitive.
Really?
Yeah, here's what the baby said to me. I said, can you hear me? And the baby went,
my daddy is so cheap, he uses lawn chairs as furniture.
The kid already knows.
Wow, somebody's been talking.
Yeah. And then the baby said,
my daddy is a bigger plug whore than Jackie Martin.
That's impossible.
And then Gilbert's baby said,
my daddy is so lame that he was booed at Belinda Carlisle's concert.
Right. You should be very proud of that. Have you met?
The baby knows Belinda Carlisle.
Yeah, oh, the baby's very intelligent.
Yes.
Are you excited? Do you have any fantasies about playing baseball with the baby or walking in the
yet.
Park?
I still like block it out of my head.
Was this an accident, Gilbert? Honestly, I mean, what happened here?
Were you set up?
This is so not typical of you. You're very much a loner. You were never into any kind of romantic love. I mean, I know that. I mean, it's not just a persona that you put on. You're very uncomfortable even sharing your apartment with someone. Is this torturous for you?
Sometimes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you seeing professional help? Are you...
That costs money, Hal.
Yeah, exactly.
You seeing any non-professional help?
Were you using birth control when this happened? Or was it an intentional thing? I'm asking you.
I don't know. I like, go from day to day to day. It's like without planning anything.
So you didn't...
no birth control.
You don't use birth control.
Yeah, no, I can't even get a hard on... But
that's good to use.
Yes.
Isn't it amazing that David Arquette and Courtney Cox had to go through all that craziness?
And Gilbert just gets a girl pregnant.
Yeah.
It's not fair.
But Gilbert, is the young lady Jewish? Will we be raising the child Jewish?
Oh, yes.
Yeah. What will you sing to the baby so that the baby will learn Jewish singing?
Do you sing it now?
Shemere
That's a sweet lullaby.
Yes, it is.
Are you singing to the babies to me now? Because they say you should talk to the babies.
Oh,
to me.
God.
Well, the baby said some interesting things to me. Gilbert's future baby. Here's what the baby had to say.
Why couldn't I have been shot out of Bobcat Goldthwait's cock? He has more of a career than my daddy.
Your child wants to be Bobcat Goldthwait's child. And then your baby said this.
Yes.
My daddy made a DVD of old jokes because he's too lazy to come up with a new act.
How is your DVD doing, all right?
Yes.
Yeah, Gilbert Gottfried, speaking of his act, tomorrow night at 8 o'clock at Caroline's on Broadway in Manhattan. Have you incorporated your new situation into the act?
No, God, that's...
You're not going
those
there.
Those comics who do that, it's just too horrible.
Not for you. All right.
Yeah.
And for reservations, you can call 212-757-4100. So you will play it like you are a single man and not attached to anyone and not having a baby.
Yeah, and I could get all the same pussy I was getting before.
Right. Yeah. And to purchase Gilbert's DVD, Dirty Jokes, go to GilbertGottfried.com. And one more thing, his baby did say this to me. And this is rather revealing.
My daddy is so cheap. He fills my baby bottle from creamers he steals at diners.
So the marriage is in, the baby's due in June.
Yeah.
Will the marriage occur before the baby comes?
I guess so, yeah.
Yes. Oh, so yeah. You got to get married before June.
So yeah. There is a date involved in the marriage?
Yeah, she's planning all that stuff.
Do you have any idea? Is it May? Is it April? I mean, that's very soon.
Yeah.
Have the invitations gone out?
I don't know. She's in charge of that.
Can you please come to the wedding?
I like run and hide when it's discussed.
But is it going to be a big ceremony? Are there going to be invitations? You're not eloping to...
No, not a big...
Who will be there?
Uh-oh, Gary's here.
What is it, Gary?
Don't turn it around, Gilbert. Now the microphone's behind your head.
Oh, okay.
You gotta
turn it around.
Oh!
What did he do?
He switched his mic.
I put my gun backwards.
I hate weddings.
He's nervous.
I tried to get out of my cousin's wedding. I hate weddings. Gilbert, please, can I come to your wedding? I would love to.
Yeah, who's going to sit on your side? You got to have people.
You can give me some advice on it.
Let me tell you about broads.
So on the honeymoon, generally, they have sex on the honeymoon.
What are you going to do with a wedding? I mean, are you going to wear a suit? And you're going to get up in front of all the people and walk down the aisle? I mean, you're going to...
Nothing that big, no.
How about a best man?
Is there a best man? Do you have anyone in mind?
Richard Lewis?
Yes.
Who is
your best man?
Fred Stoller?
Yes. Charlie Sheen.
Who is your best man?
Kip Adada.
Honestly. Yes.
Kip Adada would be a good one.
Who is your best man?
I don't have one.
No.
Are you standing there by yourself?
I have no idea. I'm like...
Wait. Yes. See, there's two issues going on here. There's one is Gilbert's not looking to get married in the first place, but then the second thing is... He's agreed to do it, and every move costs him money. You know what I mean? And there's tuxedos, and there's food, and there's flowers, and there's people. And that's making him crazy, too,
yes.
I'm sure.
Did you meet with her parents? Have you met them?
I met them, yeah.
How many times?
Oh, more times than I'd like to remember.
Do they look at you like you're a filthy Jew?
Yeah.
Now, did he didn't go and ask the dad permission to marry his daughter.
Oh, no, he would never do anything nice.
Yeah.
You know, he would never do anything nice
like that. Nothing like that, huh?
Right. So the wedding is before June.
Yes.
The invitations have gone out.
They have?
I don't know.
He knows.
Yeah,
Did you put anybody on the guest list?
It's going to be so small.
It's just going to be your family members.
We're not being invited, I don't think.
Right, you wouldn't have us there.
But Gilbert, for real, who's on your, like, you give your fiance a list. You say, okay, these are people that I need to have there. And there's I don't know if your mom's not alive anymore, but a sister. So who else is on your list?
Oh, gee, Emmanuel Lewis.
Come on.
No, but really.
Richard Lewis. Yes. All the Lewis.
All the Lewises.
Jerry Lewis. Yes.
You're very ashamed that you're getting married, aren't you?
Gary Lewis and the Playboys.
You're really upset about it. I mean, you're just freaking out.
You can't
even
talk about it.
I mean, this is so weird. You're not a romantic guy.
Yeah.
You don't really like women. I mean, you'll have sex with them, but you don't like them.
Yes.
And there must be something about this girl, though, because you said that they broke up and Gilbert had to have her back. That's how he got into this.
Gilbert, are you in love with your future wife?
Oh, jeez.
Do you love her? Do you?
Oh, sure.
Really, that was hard for you to say, wasn't it?
Oh, God, he's gulping that water like this.
I know. I'm going to be needing 3 more bottles of water before.
Have you ever said to her, I love you? To the wife? Have you ever said that? Like, I love you.
No, never. Really? I never say stuff like that.
You don't.
Yeah. Are you going to write your own vows?
Have you ever said it? She ever said I love you to her as Arthur Godfrey?
How are you?
You know, go back to the baby thing. You had asked us to get this for you. So if you go to Gary Preview page 1 in orange, you know, Doug Goodstein just had a baby.
Right.
So there's just 20 seconds of Doug's baby crying.
All right,
it's pretty amazing.
Oh.
We taped Doug Goodstein's baby.
This is what you got to look forward to.
This is real.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's so cute. That's in your apartment, Gilbert.
That sounds like a porn baby. Oh, yeah. Oh, take it.
How are you going to deal with that?
How about when that's on a plane?
What's going to be running through the father's mind when he hears his baby cry?
Here's, I interviewed the baby. Here's what the baby had to say about her future father, Gilbert Gottfried.
My daddy tells my mommy that he is way funnier than J-Lo now.
And then the baby said this.
I don't care what anybody says. I think my daddy's old Groucho impression is relevant.
Well, you can always tell your kid that you made one of the greatest phony phone calls of all time to the gay bathhouse, which
I love. Oh, it's great.
What are you, a homo? Oh!
Tommy?
Yes. Hickory dickory dock!
Oh! All right, say something worth listening to her.
Oh!
You fucking dickwad. Please stop annoying me. Why don't you come on in here and then we'll talk. You fucking asshole. Come on, come down here. Don't call me on the phone, you pussy.
What are you, a homo?
Are you?
Yes.
You have the address? Come on down and fuck with me, you little fucker.
In your face.
In your face, fuck face. Come on down here, motherfucker. Come on. Come on, pussy. Hey, that's the best you can do.
Show!
Come on down here and say it to my face, you motherfucker.
Okay.
Do it. Get down here. Hurry. Fucking knock you next week, motherfucker.
Oh, I love this.
Come on. Bring it on, motherfucker. Bring it on.
Oh, I don't like what you put down.
Dick face. Come on, bring it on.
Yes.
Fucking,
my muscles feel so much better now.
You're going to call me on the phone and be a dick. Why don't you come down here and try it, dickhead?
Oh, that's right.
Asshole.
Oh, excellent.
You love that, don't you?
Yes.
That's the best. Well, Gilbert will be at Caroline's, 8 o'clock tomorrow, Broadway, Manhattan. I don't get much of a sense of happiness about the marriage or the baby.
I don't know what to think this will come to.
I don't know. And to purchase Gilbert's DVD, Dirty Jokes, which is now number 7,149 on Amazon's DVD sales list. Congratulations.
But I have heard that we're not invited to the wedding. Who was it who helped you through that horrible illness? Your wife wasn't around.
Yeah. Oh. Howard was your wife.
Neither was your kid.
Your kid did say this to me.
Up All Night was one of the most important comedy shows in history.
Up All Night, yes.
My father doesn't even want to marry my mommy. My daddy is considered the comedian's comedian. Oh, great. That just means he never made the big time.
Wow. Your kid's got a lot to say, just like you.
Very opinionated.
If I hear Daddy do Dice Gottfried one more time, I'm going to strangle myself with my umbilical cord.
I wonder if it would be annoying having Gilbert as a father with all his impressions and
you
loud laughs.
You think he's going to do the impressions right. and all that?
Absolutely.
The baby?
Please, I'm begging somebody to abort me. I don't want to go through life being a cheap money-lending Jew.
Oh, my goodness.
When my daddy leaves for work, my mommy says, "Where did Hitler go wrong?"
Well, good for you. Gilbert, congratulations.
Yes.
Sounds like you're a real family man.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you will never have another woman again. I have a different woman.
Yeah, because right. I was getting so much before.
Right.
Yeah.
Well,
that's not a problem, really.
Does anything get to you emotionally? How do you feel about these soldiers in Iraq dying? And do you ever get political and think about the boys overseas? Or do you ever have any feelings for anything?
Yes, yes. Yeah. Yes, my boys overseas, yeah.
Wow.
See what I mean? He's very closed off. Yes. Very uncomfortable.
You think you're closed.
Yeah.
This is a dark...
This is a textbook case.
Yeah, I think, yeah. The safe has never been cracked.
You never went to a psychiatrist to get analyzed?
No.
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 Now, you go to a psychiatrist?
Yes.
How often?
3 days a week now.
Wow.
You used to go four.
Wow.
Help me. Look at me.
Yes, you changed so much.
I didn't know you cut back a day. You did?
3 days, yeah.
That's
yeah.
a big deal, isn't it?
Yeah.
When did that happen?
Well, how do you have a life? Because you're going to a psychiatrist every day. I have no other friends. Do you ever visit your mother's grave or anything? Do you ever talk to your mother at the grave? Or are you just happy she's out of the picture?
No, I have a mannequin in the room.
I see.
Does Gilbert have brothers and sisters?
He has a sister. I met his sister. Lovely woman.
Paul Winchell.
Yes.
The ventriloquist. He used to, he had a horrible upbringing with his mother.
Terrible.
And he built, a dummy of his mother that he used to scream at.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
You should do that.
You should do that.
Yes.
Did you love your mother, or did you have nothing really to do with her? Was she terrible to you? Was she make fun of you?
I was like Georgie Jessel.
Right.
Yes. Yeah, hello, Ma. It's your son. Yeah. Hi, it's Georgie. You know your son, Georgie? The one that sends you money every week. Yeah, that's the one. Yeah, so, hey, did you get that parrot I sent you? What, you ate it? Why, how could you eat that parrot? It spoke three languages. Oh, it should have said something. How's your health been doing, Mama? What, you see spots before your eyes? Well, put your glasses on. Are they on? Oh, now you see the spots more clear. Okay.
That was some act.
Yes.
Wow. Well, I got to tell you, Gilbert, everyone in the audience is very excited for
you. Yes, I'm sure.
Can't wait to see your little baby.
We can't wait to see you wheeling a carriage around Manhattan.
Yeah.
I'm sure people will get pictures of that. Anyone sees that, take a picture. Well, okay, it's time for news. I'm going to ask Steve Langford to come in, as well as John Hine, and get updates for you right now. Steve, what are you working on in the Howard 100 newsroom?
Just some of the stories we're working on in the Howard 100 newsroom. Bubba the Love God, his big Florida wedding day this weekend. A local paper there reporting in a feature story about Bubba that he met bride-to-be Heather at the Livestock Music Festival 5 years ago when she was trying to get an interview with Bubba. Bubba told her, F you then, but now Bubba and Heather will walk down the aisle this Saturday night. The Stern Show essentially airlifting itself to Florida for the great occasion. Howard 100 News there to provide full coverage.
Are you in our hotel?
No.
No?
No.
Good.
Good.
You got to keep press outside.
That's right. There's got to be separation between press and the subject. What are you wearing, Robin? Did you figure it out yet?
Yes, I found a little something.
Something short with no panties?
That's it.
I found a big something.
Did you hire Ralph to get you a suit?
Well, I don't have time. Again, it's all about Ralph. Ralph, I got
to... Oh, did you talk to him?
Well, I'm leaving yesterday for the signing, and somebody comes up to me and goes, Ralph needs you to call him immediately. And I said, well, I got to go to this fucking signing. And then the signing took till 4, and I went home and slept all night. I haven't discussed it at all. Believe me, I'll have some. I'll just wear...
You're not wearing a suit, though, right?
I'll get whatever I need to get.
All right.
Yeah.
What are you wearing, a short dress, Robin, or a long gown?
No, it's sort of mid-calf.
Mid-calf. I like you in mid-calf. With the titties. I got to say.
I got to figure out what I'm wearing to Gilbert's wedding.
I can't believe come.
The important thing is to wear pants and a jacket. And you could have a tie with it. Sometimes you should have shoes that will match the pants. Like if you have black pants, you could also have black shoes with them.
That's already giving you dressing advice?
Yes.
Yeah.
Socks go good with
you. Know
what
would be great? If Robin wore a wedding dress.
Yeah.
You know how you're not supposed to?
I should wear a wedding dress to the wedding?
A magnificent wedding dress.
You're going to catch the bouquet.
That's funny.
You'll catch the bouquet.
I told that to people. They thought it was a good idea.
Oh, that's a funny idea. Why didn't you tell me?
I'm telling you now.
I'm too late.
Steve, anything else you're covering besides the Big Bubba the Love Sponge wedding?
Ask Elliot often a simple question, and you get threats. Howard 100 News asking the one-man crime spree how he feels about scoring more than $8,000 in the Stern Show football pool, often at first refusing to answer, then demanding a second chance to respond in order to issue more threats. Howard 100 News asking why Mr. Big Mouth is so afraid to answer simple questions.
So you dealt with him again.
Yes.
Very good. Anything else?
Whack Packer Joey Boots shipping off to Iraq.
What?
Boots telling Howard 100 News he's trying to get a job in Baghdad as part of a bid to clean up his act.
I heard him on the air yesterday. He's still off the wagon. He had just been up all night doing coke or something.
Oh, my God.
He had drank a six-pack of beer already in the morning.
He was feeling great.
No, remember we reported that he fell off the wagon a couple of months ago?
Yeah.
Well, he's never gotten back on.
Wow.
Well, I heard Shuley was at my signing yesterday, and we were talking before, and he told me horrifying things about what Boots is doing now. I mean,
really?
Well, he doesn't leave his house. It's not even like a social thing. He just,
what happened to the rehab, and he felt great, and it was a whole new lease on life?
That's like ancient history.
Wow. He took a hard fall off that wagon.
Yeah, and he's in front of a computer all day on the network or whatever.
So he's not doing the Stern fan or Stern the wrap up show that roundtable show anymore.
I don't think my thing is he always he said to Shuley like, well, if I had a job that I loved, like almost a hint,
right,
I would get off the drugs. Well,
right, like if we better employ him or he's going to kill himself.
How's he buying all this blow?
I mean,
that's
know.
A lot of fucking money.
I'd like to ask
maybe
him.
He's doing favors for it.
Joe, I hope that ain't the case.
Well, then maybe he'll do us a favor and call in. What else you got there, Steve? Anything?
A New York Daily News gossip column claiming TV host Pat O'Brien is about to get dumped by the insider. Pat O'Brien's credibility never recovering, according to the story, from those rip-roaring voicemails 2 years ago that revealed Pat's inner wild child.
Save message Sunday, 7:09 p.m.
You are so fucking hot. And I want to eat you. So fucking hot. I don't want my girlfriend to eat you. So fucking hot. You are fucking hot. Just do it. You are so fucking hot. Please leave me a voicemail.
Can't believe his reputation didn't recover from that.
You know that Betsy is marrying him? I heard they got engaged over the holidays.
That's nice.
Yes. Anything else?
Stern World News tips to Howard 100 News anytime. Call us 877-33-SIRIUS. Choose Channel 100. These stories are much more coming up on the Howard 100 Noontime News. Weekdays, noon Eastern updates every hour.
Also, we're looking for mothers and sons who are interested in playing It's Just Wrong. If you want to play, give us a call at 888-9-ASSHOLE for your chance to win $5,000 from HotMovies.com. Enjoy the best in adult movies for 10 cents a minute. Get in, get off, get out. HotMovies.com. That's right. It's Just Wrong. Coming back because of the beauty of satellite radio. Considered too risque for terrestrial radio.
This is the only time I ever stepped in and said, I'm offended by something in the history of this show.
Me too. mothers and sons undressing one another.
Well,
unbelievable.
The sons have to answer questions about their mother's sex lives.
That's right.
Like they would know.
I believe a father was about to make out with his daughter.
Yes. Well, someone else's daughter, while his daughter watched, yes.
No.
I'll make
his
out
own
with
daughter? Daughter?
His own daughter. They were about to kiss.
Was I here?
Yes, you were
this
here.
Is
and
so
I actually
wrong.
Said, you know what? I'm against it.
I was against it.
Yeah,
myself.
No, you were too. But
we're all against it, but hey, they're adults.
It happens.
I don't know.
All right, let's go over to Johnny Hine. Thank you, Steve. We'll listen to those updates all day long and listen to Howard 100 News as they cover the Bubba the Love Sponge big event, the big wedding, and also John Hine has the wrap-up show today. Johnny Boy, what are you doing?
After a fierce debate, the question still lingers, whose life would you rather have and whose is more normal, Artie's or Ralph's?
Who would you rather have,
The normal question's a black and white issue.
Who would you rather be, Artie or Ralph? Seriously. Be honest.
Artie.
You would? Why?
Yes. Because when you first think about the question, I'm trying to divorce the two guys from it and think, like, Artie does this. He's a sports fan. He does this, and he's got these problems. Ralph does nothing, but he's got these problems. And if I had to put the two, I'd take Artie's life.
Who's happier? Artie is on, you know, has been known to have addictions. He's addicted to food right now.
And depression.
I mean, Ralph, here, on Ralph's plus side, he's got a pretty easy lifestyle.
He doesn't tax himself.
He's thin.
You think Ralph's not a depressed guy?
I think he is. I think there's something.
I think he's
His depression is not evidenced the same way yours is.
You don't think Ralph has ever experimented with drugs?
Oh, definitely.
Oh, absolutely.
But what are we talking about?
And had some problems.
What are we talking about here?
I don't think he's had an addiction.
I think he's been pretty bad. I mean, yes, he has had problems with drugs.
Whatever.
Like Artie looking at me like cross-eyed, like, you better pick my life over Ralph.
No, I don't care. Listen,
I agree with you.
I agree with you that... You know, he does have the life. He's a scam that he doesn't have to. But how long does that last? I mean, don't you start to feel a little empty with that? I mean, at least
no,
I...
No, Ralph doesn't feel empty.
All right. Who would you rather be? Artie or Gilbert?
Oh.
I'd rather be Gilbert's kid.
Right, let's go around the room. Robin, who would you rather be? Artie or Gilbert?
Gilbert.
Jeez.
I gotta be Artie.
I think we all know the answer to this one.
I gotta be Artie.
Why?
Because I couldn't
Robin
live Gilbert's
kids.
Life. I couldn't live Gilbert's
what
life.
What about Gilbert's
I
life? Couldn't
Gilbert
you live?
Gilbert is miserable every moment of the day. Yeah. I think Artie has a few happy moments.
What about my life? Couldn't you live? What do I do that's so horrifying?
I never take heroin. I don't want to do that
fun.
To myself.
You're extremely heavy. You are hurting your body. You smoke.
I'm 50 sit-ups, 50 sit-ups away from being a fine.
Fred, who would you rather be, Artie or Gilbert, if you had to be one or the other?
Artie, I think he gets laid more.
Gilbert gets regular sex, though. He is in a relationship.
Got a woman at
I
home.
Think he trapped her. I think, you know, even if Artie has to pay for it, he's had better chicks.
All right, let's go to...
You know what? Artie couldn't make a relationship work, though. Gilbert's getting married.
Oh, yeah, it's working.
You think it's working?
Oh, yeah.
Gilbert's laughing at that. Sorry, Gilbert.
Who would you be?
Me?
Between Artie and Gilbert.
I'm practically you now.
I think I'm going to give the edge to Artie.
So it's unanimous.
Yeah, I mean, Gilbert is really emotionally crippled inside.
Yes, he's miserable.
I don't know how it could ever be helped.
Listen, I have played Carnegie Hall.
Artie has a shot.
Which irks me every second.
As well as the Carnegie family.
Artie has a shot. At happiness? At happiness. I don't think Gilbert does.
Gilbert's off the charts.
Unhappy.
He never will make that mark.
But that's Gilbert's choice. I think Gilbert loves being this way.
Yeah.
He's clearly a smart enough guy to know how to, like, you know, get Gilbert out of certain ruts that might...
No, that's not how it works.
Do you ever wake up happy?
No.
Okay.
You ever go to sleep?
No.
Have you ever been happy?
I don't wake up in the middle of the night happy.
You know
I'm curious about something. I'm curious about something. I first saw Gilbert do stand-up at Caroline's by the Seaport. We went for my 20th birthday. So this is October of 1987. Me and 10 of my buddies, he destroyed, he killed, sold out. As a matter of fact, when we called to get reservations, this is 20 years ago now, they said, hey, look, you're going to have to wait. We might add a show with Gilbert. It's always sold out. We watched him. He does an hour. Unbelievably funny. In those days, Gilbert, did you enjoy your life? You're in your early 30s at the time, probably.
You're killing every night.
You got that kind of success.
Was there any happiness there?
Not really.
No. Really? No. Have you ever tried medication to make yourself happy? Have you ever medicated?
That medication makes you constipated, doesn't it?
And by the way, if you guys want to see that same act I saw 20 years ago, go to Caroline's this weekend.
It's the exact same hour.
It was a good act.
But were you getting pussy back then? Because, I mean, I remember me and my buddies driving home. We were like, he's an odd guy.
Yeah, he was getting tons of pussy.
He must get laid.
Ralph, you're on the air.
I'll save most of my comments for the wrap-up show. But one thing, Robin, I have never had a drug addiction or a problem.
I didn't say an addiction. You did have problems.
What problem?
You were self-medicating, and, you know, you could get out there for a while.
Like how
like binge-type stuff.
No, I've it never affects anything that I do. Okay.
You don't do anything.
I'm just doing it for fun. No,
I'm not going to talk about what I know, Ralph, but I know that you have had a problem.
No, you don't know nothing of the sort. And,
yeah,
Artie, you're an asshole because a few minutes ago you go, yeah, it's all about Ralph. He calls me. Hello?
Hello?
Yeah. He calls me to make an appointment. I was calling you to try to make an appointment to help your fat ass out. I don't need this shit.
You weren't going to charge me for this?
What's that?
Were you going to charge me for this?
Maybe yes, maybe no.
Dude, it's business for you. You're trying to get some money.
He wants to help you out.
You are really an asshole, man, if you think that's why I'm trying to help.
I'll say about it. You know what? Listen, Ralph, I'm going to say something. I'm going to get into the heat of the argument. Ralph has made, in the past, several calls to help me with this. You're right, dude. You're right.
Yeah, don't sit there and go, I'm making it all about me.
All right, we're fucking around. But this time, it did seem like it was more of a business thing. In the past, he's offered to do it for nothing, which was very nice, by the way.
I offered to set you up at Barney's and have you go down to studio service.
And, dude, that was very nice.
I'm offering to come with you because maybe you're more comfortable. You're somebody you know there because when you're all big and fat and nothing fits you, I'm going to help you.
Well, when you're saying it that nicely, I mean, my God, how could I say no?
All right. So here we go again. Thank you.
I love Artie, though.
I love you, too. Everything's fine. He did admit he has done very friendly things in the past, and I admit that.
Joey Boots, you're on the air.
Oh, Joey.
What's up, everybody? Hey, I heard you wanted me to call in for something.
Yeah, what's going on? I'm shocked to hear that you're not on the wagon, that you're completely destroying your life again.
I'm not destroying it. I'm in the midst right now of actually trying to repair it, Howard. I mean, I fell off the wagon, and I've been off it for a while, and I'm trying to do the right thing right now because I'm at the beginning of making a mess of it again.
Well, why don't you go back into rehab or something and save yourself?
I don't have the money for rehab. I didn't have it.
How do you have the money for cocaine?
I don't do it a lot. I do it now and then.
Where do you get the money for cocaine?
I don't want to say, but, you know, I
Are you turning tricks?
No, please, come on, that's funny.
Oh, God, you know what, I knew that. How much do you need for rehab?
No, that's all right.
We'll do a show. And we all be like, we'll do like a cabbie thing.
I'm not anything like cabbie. You know what it is? I need to fulfill my life with something, and so I'm trying to get employment right now.
Well, this is the best shape to be in to get it.
Yeah, no, you gotta.
Yeah, come on, Joey, you can do it.
Yeah, no, I totally know I can do it. Right now, I think the right thing for my life right now is for me to be working and doing something that gives me, fulfillment.
Right, to get a job.
Yesterday, I heard
that's
you,
where I'm
Joey.
Going right now,
and that's Baghdad where I'm going. Is the only place that you can get a job.
Oh yeah, so that hey, you know what, Howard? I'm in a lot of debt. I'm in about 25 grand debt right now, and it's a big weight on my shoulders. So I figured if I go over there and I work for a year, I'll have enough money to pay off all my debt, and I'll come back with a nice chunk of change in the bank.
All right. Well, there you go, Joey. About
who's
to take
he going
to
work for over there?
In Baghdad?
Sorry?
Who are you going to work for in Baghdad?
It's a civilian company that supports the troops overseas.
McDonald's?
No.
All right.
Boots, call Levy. If you need, we could do a show for you. It's no big deal.
No, I appreciate it, Artie, but I'm not that guy, taking handouts like that. You know, I appreciated going to rehab for not having to pay anything, and, I kind of let everybody down on that right now, I think.
All right, thank you.
Yesterday I heard you, Boots, and you said you had done cocaine and you had just had at least a six-pack of beer early in the morning.
A case of beer.
What? Yeah. A case? Oh.
Yeah, it had been up all night.
Case of beer. All right, Joey, listen, I hope you feel better. I really do, and I hope you pull it together.
Hey, I love you guys.
All right, love you too. All right. Dominic, go ahead. You were a fat guy. Where'd you get suits?
What are you talking about? Fat, fat, thin, fat. My tailor will come tomorrow morning on the air, measure Artie, deliver a suit Saturday, my treat. I don't want, not a tux, because that takes a few days, but he will have a suit. He'll come 6 in the morning, measure you, and by Saturday, it'll be delivered to you so you can wear a suit to the wedding.
And can it be delivered in Tampa?
Yes, of course. We'll overnight it. What are you talking about?
All right. Well, you know what? Do it, but I'm paying for it, Dominic. I'm not letting you pay.
Oh, you're not
paying. No, dude. That's enough that you set. It's enough that you set it up. Don't pay for it.
Dominic, are you fat again?
I gained 20 pounds.
Wow.
Dominic, yeah. Dominic.
And you want to know what else? Wow. I'm sick every day of my life.
Sick?
Why?
Yeah, I regurgitate. What do you regurgitate? What do you want me to tell you?
Oh, you mean you throw up?
Because you had your stomach made smaller?
When you say I'm fat, I lost 100 and I gained back 20, 25. Leslie says it's 30. I don't think so. But
I don't understand something. Now when you eat, because you overeat, you vomit?
Yes.
Oh.
Yes, I do. And my Dr. Currian is screaming at me. She wants to tighten the band. And it's a very...
Why are you not tightening the band then?
I am Friday.
He'll throw up more.
What are you doing? You're just eating past where the band is?
You fool the band. You trick it. What you do is...
Can you get a smarter band?
They need a smart band.
How do you trick the band in your stomach?
Okay, well, because you're always interested in that issue, and I'll give you the answer. If you have a couple of drinks, and you eat a little bit in the beginning, all of a sudden it relaxes too much. I don't know why. And they promised me that I would keep off 70 to 75% of the weight. So that's correct, because don't forget, I was 315, Howard.
Right.
And I went down to 200. I'm back to 220. I have no suits. I'm buying all new clothes or the bypass, which I'm a little afraid of, because people die from that. But more important is Artie. I will have someone there tomorrow.
Dominic, I'm telling you right now, book it. I think that would be funny to have him measure me on the air, but I insist on paying for it. That you're doing me a huge favor here because I can get it done at work.
For me, please. Well, you can do whatever you like, but I will call my tailor. I already called him once about it. He said he'd definitely come in. He'll measure you on the air. He'll get an extra sewer to come in on Friday. Get a little extra material.
Wow, that's nice. All right. Thanks, Dominic.
All right, I'll give him the address.
No, he'll come to the show tomorrow.
Well, no, I'm saying I'll give him the address where to send it in Tampa Saturday.
Sure.
All right.
We'll get it over, and I'll have him there tomorrow morning at 6 a.m. because he's got to start working right away.
All right. Thanks, Dominic.
Anthony the tailor. He used to make all my fat suits, and I think I'll be back there.
Well, square it with Gary or Jason or somebody so he can get up here.
All right. Thanks.
I'll call Gary later.
All right. Bye-bye.
Okay?
Right.
Dominic, I love you, but look, I'll just bring in my checkbook tomorrow. I'll pay the guy
directly.
That's
how.
There you go. You're a class guy.
But no, yeah. I mean, I don't know.
Gilbert says take it for free.
Yeah.
That's what an amazing favor that is. That's
all
great.
Right. That's very nice. Anything else, John?
See, Ralph?
Full play. That's how you do it. Yeah, go ahead.
We're going to talk about David Arquette and Gilbert and your theory on cops and what to do when you get pulled over, but I think this debate's going to go on for a very long time.
Yeah, I think there's a lot of show in there, and I can't wait to hear Johnny Hine today at 11 o'clock on the wrap-up show. Now let's go over to Robin and her theme song as we listen to the news.
Phone bags and shake for me.
I don't either.
Black tits.
Really, I love
that. Grease up those big
jaws
and slide on you.
Don't you love black tits?
Black tits. I will ice down your nipples and tug on them.
Yeah. You guys are perv.
Black tits. I must see those otters, those chocolatey otters.
This guy.
You know, I was at a bachelor party once when I was working at the port. A guy was fucking a black hooker, and he said to her, how much is it? Do you mind if I say dirty shit? And she's like, yeah, I don't care. He goes, do you mind if I get racial? That turns me on. And she's like, I don't give a shit, whatever, you know. So he pays her, and he got kicked out of the room within a second. We're like, what the fuck did you say? He goes, I don't know. I said, can I say whatever I want? I paid her good money. I'm like, what did you say? He goes, I said I wanted to fuck her nigger tits.
Oh, jeez.
I didn't throw him out. Oh, thank God there's some decency.
She got up. Yeah. Get the fuck out of
somebody
here.
Somebody draws the line.
Did you go right? What about warming her up? You went right to the N-word?
You have to work up to that.
What scare
him. Oh, that's awful.
She'd start throwing shit at him. Get the fuck out of here.
You got some friends. I got to meet your friend.
Well, yeah.
Well, that's actually the same guy who was the cop. But anyway,
Gilbert's here. See Gilbert tomorrow.
That's what it sounded like.
See Gilbert.
I will adopt a cop.
See Gilbert Gottfried tomorrow night at 8 o'clock at Caroline's on Broadway in Manhattan. For reservation, call 212-757-4100. And to purchase Gilbert's DVD, Dirty Jokes, go to GilbertGottfried.com. And Robin, what is in the news?
Yo! Do you know James Brown?
Did I mention I want to fuck your nigger dinner?
That was the wrong story to tell.
Gilbert
at the beginning of the news, that was the wrong story.
That's my new pickup line.
You sure your friend wasn't Gilbert?
All right, it was Gilbert.
All right.
James Brown's body still hasn't been buried.
Why?
I wonder how many times James Brown said that.
I don't think James Brown ever said that. The body of the soul singer has not yet been buried more than a week after his funeral. Now, they've already had the funeral.
They've got to pass it around to every black opera house in the country.
Oh, that's awful.
The family and attorneys have not settled many issues surrounding his estate, so they need the body up. You know, the estate has nothing to do with the body.
Well, James Brown wants to be in any arguments over his estate.
So he can't be buried until everything's settled.
He wants to be a presence.
Including where he's to be laid to rest. So they're even arguing about where to plant him. His attorney, Buddy Dallas, said his Beach Island, South Carolina home remains locked to protect his memorabilia, furnishings, clothes, and other personables. And that's exactly where he is. He's locked inside the house.
Wow.
The manager of the funeral home in Augusta, Georgia, who handled the memorial service, says Brown's body is being kept at a controlled temperature in a sealed casket at
his home. You don't want him reeking up the place.
Until the details can be worked out.
It is weird.
I keeps him in the refrigerator with my Swanson's dinners.
Oh, stop.
It is weird to think that James Brown can't be even put to sleep.
Yeah,
I mean, you'll put the final
he's
rest.
He's so contentious they can't even put him in the ground.
He's even the hardest working dead guy
in show business.
And I heard they changed his clothes they were having a bunch of different funerals and they changed his clothes.
Outfit change?
Of course.
Yes.
Yes.
What are you talking about? Of course you do.
Gilbert's like, I'm not even going to change my clothes for my wedding.
Also in the news, a guy was trying to embezzle money from Yoko Ono.
I read about that, yes.
You know, clean her out.
They have released, you think anybody should have that?
Yeah,
I'd like to fuck her chink tits. Yes.
That's not nice.
Stop it.
That's not funny.
This guy was her chauffeur for many years, and he was trying to get $2 million from her to keep from publishing a letter. In the letter, he accuses John Lennon of being a wife beater. He says he had tape.
I bet John Lennon. Stop? John Lennon said that.
What?
Our greatest songwriter ever said, I want to fuck your chink tits.
I'd like to fuck your chink tits. I want to fuck your big droopy yellow tits. You got yellow tits like Maude Simpson. I'd like to fuck your big chink yellow tits.
The guy alleged that he had tapes of Sean Lennon calling his father a wife-beating asshole.
Wow.
Wasn't Sean like real young when he died too? Like,
yeah, but apparently Yoko must have told him stories and one day he was talking to a friend according to this guy, and this is what he referred to his father as.
Wow, wad to a 10-year-old kid.
The guy, Carl Coco Carson, also threatened that unless Yoko came up with the money, he'd divulge tapes of her political statements against the U.S. and British governments, and critical comments about her family and friends and the Beatles. Those friends include Jackie Onassis,
Jackie Martley,
Rolling Stone founder Jan Winner, and her longtime family publicist Elliot Mintz.
Yeah, that creep who's with Paris Hilton. Now, you ever hear that guy Elliot Mintz talk?
Yes, I have.
Don't know him. Hey,
he also threatened to poison Ono. So he's now charged.
I'd like to poison your yellow tits.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
He was going to tell all kinds of things like the numerous fights he would have with her boyfriend, Sam Havidoy. and all kinds of things. Sean Lennon had years ago called the Beatle Dad a bit of an asshole and a macho pig in interviews.
Yeah, the reason you're fucking living the life of all time right now.
Statements they say he later backed off, but he never has been quoted as calling his father a wife beater, according to Elliot Mintz.
Speaking of fathers in the email, Howard's father is one of the best guests you guys can possibly have. I could listen to him for hours. Is there any way you can get him back on the air to do his own show again? I'm working on it.
They don't want to come in and do a show.
Nah, they're not crazy about it. It would be great to have Mrs. Stern, too, for a balance, but you have got to get this guy on the air more often while he's still able to get around vertically. Oh, that's nice. Also, Rosie versus Trump. You guys can't be that fucking serious about Trump and Rosie. I think that Trump blasting her is funny. Rosie's a big bully and she can't take it. Who said we didn't think it was funny?
Oh, we do think it's funny. Yeah. It was Artie who was poo-pooing.
This guy blasts me. He says, Howard sucks. You're a Donald Trump apologist. Rosie defended that girl. She said, who is he to judge her in the first place? She didn't think the girl needed a second chance because she was fine to begin with. You suck, Howard. You sucked up to him when A.J. Benson was on and you lied. I like Donald Trump on this show. I think he's one of the best guests ever.
Absolutely.
I don't know. If that's sucking up, fine. I enjoy him as a guest.
I don't think we've really taken sides in this whole thing. We've just been delaying it out.
I admire Trump for what he did. As a fucking heroin addict, he should give everybody a second chance. So I'm for that. But I think, and Rosie was wrong for maybe criticizing him. I had a problem with what he said to her afterwards. It was a little harsh, I think, you know.
You thought it was too much when he called her a fat pig that kind of stuff.
Kind of, yeah, you know.
Mm-hmm. Well, it continues in the paper today. I mean,
there's another letter.
I should read that letter out loud.
Yeah.
Shouldn't I? Donald Trump wrote a letter to Rosie O'Donnell. Like, he won't let go of this. And
I got it here. Walters has gotten herself really in a pickle.
Yeah, I wonder what the outcome is going to be.
You need it? It's right here.
Oh, thanks, man. Listen to this. Dear Rosie, I hope you had a wonderful vacation with your wife. You needed the rest. An article in today's New York Post indicates that you blew up at Barbara Walters for being a liar. Actually, I don't blame you, but in fact, she lied to both of us. After your maniacal and foolish rant against me 2 weeks ago, Barbara called me from her vacation. I did not call her in order to apologize for your behavior. So Trump's claiming Barbara Walters called him.
Right.
She had heard that I was going to retaliate against you and tried to talk me out of it. She very much wanted me to go on the show as soon as she got back so that she could patch things up. I said no. To be exact, she said to me that working with Rosie O'Donnell is like living in hell. And more pointedly, Donald never get into mud with pigs. And don't worry, she won't be here for long. Barbara knows exactly what she told me over the phone, and she has to live with it. Perhaps that's why her initial statement was so mild. In another incident, when I saw her eating at Le Cirque about 2 months ago and asked her how Rosie was doing, she sarcastically rolled her eyes and said, Donald, do you have to ruin my meal? In any event, you've got good reason to be angry. Please give my warmest regards to Kelly. He likes getting on that Kelly thing, too.
Oh, yeah.
P.S. I was surprised that you let your spat with Barbara get into the newspapers, but as I have always said, and you proved it with Rosie the magazine, you are very self-destructive. You must work on this for your own good. Oh, he is just blasting.
He's just going and going and going.
That's right. So, Donald Trump.
But, you know, now that I'm reading this, Barbara was just trying to get Trump to do the show.
Right. Right.
You know, she was saying whatever it took to get him to not blast Rosie O'Donnell in public and to come on and do the show and let her be peacemaker.
Yeah, I guess.
Great show. That'd
so it doesn't sound like she was sincerely upset with Rosie unless, you know, like she is always upset with Rosie, but she was going to use it anyway.
Gilbert, are the wheels turning for you? Are you thinking maybe of making up a Hollywood-type feud so you can get on the paper?
Oh, yeah.
Yes. You want to start a fight with someone? No. All right. Go back to sleep.
Yes.
You know how many times Gilbert's called Rosie a fat pig? No press at all.
But I looked at the video.
I'm going to have a feud with Gallagher, too.
There you go.
Yes.
Gallagher, too.
You think that might happen?
Larry,
we would love
the
that.
Cable guy.
Oh, yes.
Oh, that would be a good feud.
But I looked at the video of the Rosie or the Barbara Walters apology on The View yesterday, and Rosie really didn't. She wasn't all that ecstatic about it. The look on her face when Barbara apologizes is sort of like, yeah, you better have said that, bitch.
That's right.
I mean, there's some rough waters going on over there at The View. Makes it more exciting to think about watching it anyway. Meanwhile,
can you imagine what Kelly has to put up with living with this pig face?
Oh,
her girlfriend cannot be happy. You look at that mess that she's got to look at every night, that she's got to kiss every night. She can't be thrilled. kissing Rosie O'Donnell. Can you imagine that? That's what's worse than that?
Oh.
Wow.
I heard the girlfriend said, I'd like to fuck your dyke tits. Yes.
That was Rosie is really somebody that she's unattractive in every sense of the word. From a physical standpoint, she looks like hell. Inside, she's far worse than she is on the outside. And I understand Rosie. But Rosie inherently is a loser.
Plan to follow through with your threat to sue her.
Well, you know, taking money out of her big fat ass would be probably something that's very easy. And we probably will follow through with it, yes.
Wow.
Amazing.
Wow, my God.
Well, Rosie O'Donnell's disgusting. I mean, both inside and out. You take a look at her, she's a slob. She talks like a truck driver. Rosie attacked me personally because I was very happy when her talk show failed. The other thing that failed, and this was a real monster, and everybody was suing her, was her magazine. Her magazine called Rosie was a total disaster. So I loved it. I gloat over it. I think it's wonderful because I like to see bad people fail. Rosie failed. I'm happy about it. She's basically a disaster. Well, she called me a snake oil salesman. And, you know, coming from Rosie, that's pretty low because when you look at her and when you see the mind is weak. I don't see it. I don't get it. I never understood. How does she even get on television? I believe Barbara made a terrible mistake putting her on, and I think Barbara's probably paying a big price. If I were running The View, I'd fire Rosie. I mean, I'd look her right in that fat, ugly face of hers. I'd say, Rosie, you're fired. We're all a little chubby, but Rosie's just worse than most of us. But it's not the chubbiness. Rosie is a very unattractive person, both inside and out. Rosie's a person that's very lucky to have her girlfriend.
Jesus. Wow.
It just went on and on,
man. He really blasted her good.
But I did find it interesting that Rosie was upset. She said, you know, one of the things she yelled at Barbara was that I have reporters outside my house with my wife and kids.
Right.
You know, she's into that whole wife thing.
By the way, Donald Trump is not the only person talking. Gilbert's baby that is due in June.
Is Gilbert's baby commenting on the Rosie-Trump feud?
Yeah, I don't know about that, but the baby is talking already about Gilbert and how she feels about being his kid.
My daddy is so cheap. He still has his gift basket from his Arsenio appearance in 1986. Wow. Does anyone want to hear my daddy do his impression of a toaster? It's the greatest. I can't wait to get my hands on Daddy's Aladdin money when he croaks.
Right, Aladdin money.
Every penny of it, I bet.
That kid's going to be very, very well off with that Aladdin money.
When my daddy leaves for work, my mommy says, where did Hitler go wrong?
You know, his baby starting to repeat jokes.
I know.
Baby.
She's taking
mommy
after me.
Mommy tells me, don't worry. Daddy is old and will die soon. Then we will be rich and I can have a fun young father to play with.
Do you think Gilbert's kid will be one of those cool kids who actually have a social life and friends?
Yes.
And Gilbert will resent every second of that child's happy life?
Well, if the baby looks like the mother, Gilbert will spend a lifetime resenting that child. Yeah, sure.
The first trimester, the Dracula voice was great, but after 7 months, it's getting a little repetitive.
Dracula voice, yes.
Do you know my daddy was on one of the most important seasons of SNL? He was almost in a sketch. Honest.
Kid's got a nasty sense of humor.
Anything else, Robin?
Yes, Jason Kidd, the basketball star of the Nets, is accusing his wife of battering him now.
That's something I never understand.
He once was arrested and had to do an anger management course because he hit her and gave her a fat lip.
He's got to be kidding.
Years ago. But he says it's almost since their wedding day. She's been throwing things at him, pinching him, kicking him, and she has been surveilling him. She put tracking devices on all of his cars and would grab his cell phone. She has the kids doing things to him. And then, I guess it was a week or two ago, she actually left the kids sitting wherever they sit, and she got herself a first row seat, and she was taunting him from the sidelines.
Wow.
I was like, boy, I got to get to a Nets game.
Yeah.
But, yeah, so he has now filed for divorce.
Hmm.
citing irreconcilable differences, obviously, and he got a restraining order against her. He said that she would try to prevent him from going to practices by lying in front of the car. She sat on the hood of his car once and made him late for practice. It's just been one thing after another. She's also threatened to call 911 and make fictitious domestic violence reports against him. He is now out of the family home, and he has filed his restraining order, and he is also filing for divorce. Her representatives obviously say this is all untrue. He's 6'4", she's 5'3", and 110 pounds. She's not doing anything to him. They think these allegations are absurd.
The Nets are in first place in what might be the shittiest division in the history of sports. They're in first place. They're 15-19 in the NBA Atlantic division.
Well, he's a little distracted.
By the way, do you know that Riley Martin was on the air last night with the show? I just want to remind people they're missing some great radio if they don't hear Riley.
Well, Riley was on. Jackie Martling was on.
Yes, there was a little Jackie Martling show. Jackie's Joke Hunt was on the air.
It was Dirty Limerick Night.
Yes.
Oh, we got to hear a few of those.
I've got all that. Actually, Riley called Jim McClure. And I know Riley says that once in a while that, you know, he drinks a few beers, but he's not really drunk. But he sounds a little tipsy in this thing.
Maybe he doesn't know what drunk is.
This is Riley calling Jim, one of the guys who works here. Jim just had a baby. And Riley.
Actually, I'm sorry, Howard. It was Jim's sister had a baby.
Oh, Jim's sister had the baby? Yeah, Riley wants a picture of Jim's sister's baby so he can make a special ticket for her, for the baby to be safe when the aliens come.
Really?
Yes.
Received Saturday, January 6th at 2:48 a.m.
Hey, Jim. Yeah. I want a picture of the baby when the baby's, you know, whenever, you know, you settle. Of course, you know, put Jim, the baby is beautiful, I'm sure. And, you know, I want a picture. Okay, I talked to Penny Crone today. And, now, basically, I'm probably fell in love with her, too. Okay. Now, I want the correct spelling of her name. I want you to call me and give me the correct spelling of her name. Okay? And how you doing, man? Miss you. We miss you, man, you know. Because I thought about the third or fourth time you came over here, then you're going to say something out the way where we could jump on and beat your ass down or something, you know?
What's he talking
about?
Come on,
you were still a gentleman. Anyway, take care. Give everybody my best wishes for the year. It's going to be a bumper crop year because we ain't taking no prisoners, basically, you know. So, okay. Take care, Jim, and give me a call, man. I want to know how you do. You think I don't love you or something, motherfucker? So, take care now. God bless. Bye.
You sounded particularly incoherent.
Yeah.
You know, I speak some black drunk. And actually, he was just saying, check out the new Apple phone. It's great.
Oh, okay. Gilbert Gottfried here tomorrow night at 8 o'clock at Caroline's in Broadway, Manhattan, 212-757-4100. Gilbert still has his DVD, Dirty Jokes. GilbertGottfried.com. It's like number 7,000 on Amazon list. So it's moving up.
Oh, and I'll be at Governor's in Levittown on the 20th.
All right. Making money for your new baby.
Yes.
Isn't that great?
That's the college fund.
Oh, you're really doing well.
College fun tour.
I realize you were playing Governors.
Yes.
All right, we're going to take a break. We'll be back. Robin will finish up the news right after these words. La, 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 la. Beautiful music in honor of Gilbert's pregnancy. And Gilbert Gottfried joins us. He'll be at Caroline's at 8 o'clock on Broadway, Manhattan. Go see him. We'll be at Governor's, what, next Tuesday, I believe?
Oh, yes. Maybe. 20th.
And to purchase Gilbert's DVD, Dirty Jokes, go to GilbertGottfried.com. We were in here trying to decide whether to have Frankie Valiant as a guest, the guy from the Four Seasons.
Oh, wow.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yes, yes, yes.
The Joe Pesci stuff alone from his life. It's such
Didn't you meet him? Yeah.
Well, I could bring it, you know, not that you care about this, but I could bring in when I met him as a baby.
Yeah.
With
that,
you know, I just said, you know, care
nobody
about
cares
it.
About that. I'm saying.
Well, there you go. Look at that lovely
picture.
Look
at those shorts. You got to ask about that.
Yeah. What was going on?
The publicist said he'd be willing to talk about everything. So before I saw the play, that was meaningless to me. But, you know, there was, like, mob involvement, and there was stuff with his family.
Fascinating. You remember, Paul Anka? I better be even better than Paul Anka. Right?
He lost money. He went through, like, fortunes three different times.
His daughter OD'd on heroin. Yeah.
Which they said he would talk about.
Wow.
He's on The Sopranos. I'm just trying to think of what else he's been involved in. Joe Pesci was one of the guys that helped the band get started.
I mean, I think the Four Seasons are real talented. It's not my kind of music, but I certainly appreciate what he does and all that. But I don't know. Does anybody want to hear me interview the guy from the Four Seasons?
I don't know what kind of interview he is, but he had an interesting life.
Fascinating.
I mean, he's made a Broadway show.
Let's leave it up to Dracula Gottfried. Dracula, do you want to see Four Seasons of Frankie Valli on the show?
His dead daughters lie in a coffin with me.
Oh, God.
Frankie Valli's daughters.
You don't want to say that.
Rise from the grave every day.
Like a magic eight ball.
Well, if Gilbert's here, maybe we'll have him in. Frankie Valli put a knife in his head.
Yes.
Dracula Gottfried, you want to have him? Do you want to have him on the show, though?
And I want him and his dead daughter.
No, not that.
Yeah.
He can't stop.
He's from the Stephen Crane Village in Newark. That's a big thing, right, for you guys?
No. All right, why don't you book him, then, if everybody's high on
book him. Book him.
I have to, you know, it's funny, though.
Does he want to sing a song?
I mean, he could be a great guest.
I don't know. I don't know. We were thinking he could be like a Paul Anka, because he's had
what's
a full life.
What's the song, Frankie Valli? The name is biggest song.
Let's hang on.
They call me.
Let's hang on
to what we got.
Big girls don't cry.
Did he write those songs or did someone else?
No, well, there was another guy.
There was another guy that wrote them that he hooked up with. And
but I think he was in the band.
The guy in the band wrote them.
That's right.
Yeah. The guy in the band wrote them. But I thought Frankie Valli, did the guy write the lyrics and the music?
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah, another guy wrote
him. Yeah, he was the genius writer.
You know, that guy's the only guy. That guy seems like he's worth a ton of money right now, just living it up.
Yeah, I'll tell you, like,
I don't know if a lot of people care. I mean, I'd be interested in the guy, but I don't know if a lot of people.
And what is the Joe Pesci story?
Joe Pesci's actually portrayed in the play, but Joe Pesci was sort of helpful in putting the band together. He was a guy from the neighborhood. And I think Joe Pesci in the play, they say that he introduced Frankie Valli to that guy that wrote all the songs. He put those two together.
Tommy DeVito is a guy. This guy, Tommy, it's funny because...
That's right, Gilbert? Who gives a shit?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
You know, Howard, I had very strange moments in the office the other day. Jessica Hahn and who else's name came up? Oh, Waylon Flowers and Madam, right? Just these two names came up, and I turned to the interns and I said, who knows who either of these people are? And they all stared at me blankly.
Right.
Just stared at me blankly.
Like, I know who Waylon Flowers and Madam are, and I know who Jessica Hahn is.
Wait
to
hear,
hear
that pitch.
But I bet
wait to hear that pitch.
But I bet they
Flowers
know Frankie
and Madam,
Valli.
The guy's dead who does
well, okay,
Flowers.
You ready? Can I do
Madam's
this on the air?
Coming in on her own.
Can I do this?
That's a booking.
This is so worth I got to do it on the air. This is the rap. We get a phone call. When Joan Rivers was in about a month or two ago, you told Joan Rivers that she's starting to look like Madam.
Right. Okay?
Apparently, according to this person that was Waylon Flowers' assistant for years, it caused this big, like, people started calling.
A resurgence.
So she has now gone out and found somebody new to work the puppet, and she'd like them to come in.
Oh, I don't want to see that. Someone works the Madam puppet?
That isn't
Waylon
Flowers.
Waylon Flowers, yeah.
It was, the whole thing was Waylon
so
Flowers.
Does he sit with...
Yes, yeah, he works the sticks.
But
I'll
he
never forget.
He's not partnered with Madam.
Waylon Flowers and Madam was this act that Madam is like a puppet, you know, and this gay dude worked the puppet, so he allowed him to be a woman, kind of, you know. So anyway, we decided NBC, we couldn't get guests, so we had Waylon Flowers and Madam.
We did anybody at that time.
So this guy shows up, the guy who, you know, Waylon Flowers, and he whips out the Madam puppet, and I said to the dude, look, it's not even necessary. We're on the radio.
Right.
Just do the voice. You know, pretend you got the puppet. He goes, no, I got to have the puppet. So now I'm like, okay. So they say, no, I'm doing a radio show with the puppet,
yes.
Madam puppet, and he's standing there talking next to the puppet, and boy, does that break the illusion. It's so fucking confusing. And I'll tell you what, it was hilarious watching this gay dude working the puppet.
Right, if you could have seen it, you would have
laughed. Well, oh, hello, hello.
The part of the story that we were amused by was that you talked about Artie's movie every day for a month, and we couldn't get 10 million people to see it. One fleeting mention of Madam, and now there's a huge resurgence.
Do you really believe that?
Yeah.
It was just a great pitch. It was a funny pitch.
Anyway.
So Frankie Valli.
Frankie Valli. Okay, well, we'll take a go around. Fred, who do you say?
I want to say no.
No, there's a no. Artie.
Absolutely yes.
There's a yes, but Artie also has an emotional thing with his father.
That's not true. I think the guy's got a... First of all, his... a show that's the biggest show on Broadway right now is based on his life. I mean, it's got to be, that's kind of interesting.
Dracula Gottfried, you said yes.
His career is deader than mine.
All right. So you say yes anyway.
Yes.
Yes, okay. Yes.
I mean, he's not playing governor.
Money he has, and does right. I mean, does the play make him money?
Does he have a dirty joke DVD?
I'd like to know if Gilbert has any money.
Yeah. Well, Gilbert's got every penny ever made.
I got a weird booking.
What?
Frankie Valli and Madam together.
Sounds like Caesar's Palace.
Sounds like the Merv Griffin show.
You guys are shitting on one of the greatest singers of all time.
I ain't shitting on him. I'm just saying, dude, will the audience care? There's a lot of younger people in our audience.
All right. Okay. So what is it? 1-1 now. What is it?
No, Fred said no. Artie said yes.
Dracula
said yes. It's 2-1,
Dracula
yes.
Dracula Gottfried said yes. And Robin said yes. I
yeah.
Well, then and I say yes.
All right, then yes.
All right, so he gets booked.
Cry,
probably
yay,
hear
yay.
This and say, I don't want to come in now.
Because right. She's going to go, hey, that's not fair. I should have Frankie Valli.
Think about the
mic. It's going to be us, FM Good Guys. We did Saturday night.
We play Frankie Valli.
Frankie Valli.
The next
Frankie Valli and Cousin Brucey. Hand in hand.
You know, there is some big Cousin Brucey connection. I'm trying to remember what it was. I read
this
it somewhere.
Right here.
This is my team. Cousin right. Brucey. Show you Cousin Brucey got his theme song. Come Four Seasons. That's why every house I have a Frankie Valli. Frankie Valli Four Seasons.
The next big thing I have to ask, and you know, be honest, I don't want to annoy you. Can my mother come up that day and meet
yeah,
him?
Yeah, sure.
All right, okay.
She can make out with him.
You can bring Grandma Caprio.
What would you do if Frankie Valli?
Grandma Caprio can't move.
What would you do if Frankie Valli became your stepfather?
I'd be the happiest motherfucker ever.
Right. That would be the only man worthy.
You kidding me? I tried to get Sam Simon to be my stepfather. The whole point of that deal was to try to get Sam to marry my sister or mother.
You don't want to make conditions for Artie's mother to come see Frankie Valli?
What is that?
I said, you don't want to make conditions for my his mother?
No, it's Artie's mom.
Bring what on you Frankie do, ride Valli.
The yeah, the Artie's that? Mom's got to get on the Sibian yeah. with Frankie Valli.
Yeah. I say, bring on Frankie Valli with Murray the King.
What about Don K. Reed and the doo-wop show?
All right, Artie has to lose 10 pounds in order for his mom
there
to
come. There you go.
Fuck that.
Dice Gottfried, what do you think? You want to see Frankie Valli?
Oh, his career was over before mine was. Oh.
Robin, what else is in the news?
We were talking about the Irwin family yesterday. We were talking about Bindi Irwin getting her own TV show. She's going to be Bindi the Jungle Girl.
Right.
I'd like to Bindi her over.
Oh. And today...
Hey, Bindi, you want a Bindi on it?
Oh. Dice Gottfried, always sexually aroused.
Yes.
The pedophile Dice Gottfried.
Right.
I'll sting you with my sting.
The wife of Steve Irwin was given the tape of his dying, you know, when
she
he got...
She destroyed it.
Yeah. Did she?
Yep. Yeah, they
no,
say it will
no,
never
no,
be seen.
No, no, no. They
it
said
will
it
never
would
be
never
seen.
Be seen. It was given to her. Nobody said it was destroyed.
Well, if Bindi Irwin's show goes down in the ratings, if they say they'll show
I
that tape, it'll go up.
You know what? They leaked the Saddam Hussein hanging tape, and we can't get the Steve Irwin.
I know.
I want to see that.
I don't know why the family is pushing Bindi Irwin to be a television star. You know what I mean? Like, it's kind of weird. Steve Irwin, okay, he was into animals. He was interesting. You watched him wrestle crocodiles. That was kind of cool. I understand the appeal.
I understand that they must be crazy, though, these people.
Yeah, they must be. Because, I mean, like, who cares if Bindi Irwin's on TV? Like, the mom should just say, you know what? Dad's dead. He had a horrible ending to the fucking animals. And, you know, I don't need Bindi going into this line of work just because her dad was in it. Let her have her own personality.
What they're basically doing is shoving her at the animals to be eaten.
Next thing you know, she's going to have to wrestle a stingray. me daddy told me to go wrestle the stingray, or whatever the fucking accent is. And, I mean, it's ridiculous. And, like, you know what? Let the kid be a little kid. Am I right or am I wrong?
I agree with you completely. It's ridiculous. It's child abuse.
Bindi Irwin's on tour. She's working with the Wiggles. I mean, come on. What is this?
It's that time to grieve.
Hi, everybody. It's Bindi Irwin. It's like, you know what? She's 9 years old. Let the kid be a kid. I'm
throw
sorry.
Another stingray on the barbie.
Hey, Bindi, want to swim around my stingray? Oh!
That's got to be very controversial. He'll say anything. He'll say anything to get left.
We haven't brought the...
I've been out of that one. I'm saving you.
Whoa.
I'm saving you.
Gilbert.
Gilbert, you're a father.
How do you dump out the title of Dice's autobiography?
I had a dump. I don't normally dump on satellite, but I saved the man. He's obviously having a nervous breakdown.
At least until his daughter or son arrives, he should be able to walk the streets.
For the audience, it involved the story I told earlier. And
all right, let's
and
go to Robin.
Godfrey,
Robin, go ahead, please.
I was just about to talk about the Baseball Hall of Fame. They had the vote.
Yeah, what happened
this
there?
This year, Tony Gwynn and Cal Ripken got in with an overwhelming
first ballot. It should be both
positive vote on the first ballot. Mark McGuire, they said, probably wouldn't get 25%.
Wow.
Well, he didn't. He got 23%. And there's one sports writer.
He's insane.
I'm just going on. There's one sports writer who refused to vote.
Hey, Gilbert, what is
he's thinking about what he said. It's really outrageous.
What does Dice Gottfried want to do to Tony Gwynn?
No, I don't want to know. No more Dice Gottfried today.
Listen to me.
Wait, have we not learned a thing from Michael Richards?
No.
Wait, so McGuire didn't get in?
McGuire only got 23% of the vote.
They failed because of the steroid, alleged steroid use.
He's not getting in because of the steroids. And there's one reporter who, you know, is supposed to have voting rights. He refuses to vote at all because this whole era has been the steroid era, and he doesn't know who did it and who didn't. So he, you know, Cal Ripken could have gotten in with a unanimous
vote. No way.
This guy refused to vote, and therefore...
So, certain guys you know, Ripken and Tony Gwynn, I don't think did. Steroid,
here's baseball but... writer Paul...
Bindi Irwin.
No, Bindi Irwin. Get him off it. Yeah.
Here's why he won't vote for anyone for the Hall of Fame. Number 7.
All right, number 7. Here we go.
I have trouble at this point voting for anyone who played in the steroids era simply because I don't feel I have enough information. We don't have enough information to make a character judgment of that magnitude at this time.
Is that fat guy from Philly? He sounds familiar. Who is that guy?
I don't know where he's from. I just know his name, Paul Ledewski.
Oh, yeah, he probably just wants to get some publicity. Yeah. That's stupid.
Here's Hall of Famer Cal Ripken, glad to be in the hall. Number 5.
All right, Cal Ripken, all happy.
It's a euphoric feeling. It's a great feeling. It's a sense of contentment all wrapped up in one, but there was also a little sense of relief and that you could relax a little bit.
You get into the Baseball Hall of Fame.
What does that mean to you?
I think it means more like when you go to those dopey signings and you have to charge people money for your signature. I think you get more money.
Really?
Absolutely. I mean, it's like Oscar winner and, you know, for your cachet and the show business.
Yeah, but your career's over. At least if you're an Oscar winner, you can get better movies.
It meant more to, like, the Mantles and Mazes because they needed the money.
Right.
But nowadays, they don't care.
It's a sad day now when, you know, baseball players charge kids for their signature.
I know.
I don't know, man. It's just...
But they never... I mean, a lot of these guys nowadays, they make enough money they don't have to
they
do
don't.
That.
Yeah. My favorite story ever is when Pete Rose was about to break the hit record, every night he wore 7 T-shirts underneath the shirt so he could sign every one of them. Sell every one of the shirt he was wearing. That's the best. Gilbert would do something.
Gilbert's just writing that down.
Gilbert's like, hey, if I could sign... If Gilbert signs his DVD, charges people more for it. Right?
He does.
Well, how much is it? Like,
is very important.
The DVD costs how much money? Like, how much?
You know, I don't know how much it's being charged for
online. You don't.
Go to his website.
I actually don't. Yeah, you could look that up.
But I know it's like $10 more if you sign it.
Yeah, 10.
Yeah. Dude, I think it goes from $12 to like $30.
Now, what do you do, Gilbert? I mean, do they just bring a certain amount in every month or so for you to sign?
Oh, yeah. And then I...
Now, how's it work? It's a business thing. You know, they come in with a big
crate.
Hey, here's the chick who's going to come on our show. She's on the she's in this month's Playboy, the girl from Battlestar Galactica, that TV show I watch.
Oh, yeah. What's her name again?
Trish Helfer.
Okay.
Completely naked, man.
She needs to change her name. Her name doesn't stick with you.
I got an advance of the Playboy. Look at
my cock will stick with you. Oh!
Here's a picture of her.
You left out an important word.
No. Here's a picture in a in
holy
the
shit.
Here's those a picture of her in
topless, huh?
Topless.
I'd love to fuck her honky tits.
Here's her.
I'd like to fuck her white tits. Yeah.
Here she is sitting on a lounge chair.
I gotta get into this.
Gilbert wants to see too.
Oh, all right.
I already took home for my own pleasure the chick from before.
Wow.
Look at the Caesar girl you took home?
Yeah, I did. I took
She's
her
on picture. Battlestar Galactica. She's really good looking. She plays a robot. Plays a machine, a Cylon.
She makes the show ungay.
Yep. Yeah. There's nothing gay about that
this
show.
This show was never gay, Artie.
It's really good.
Oh, yeah?
Very dangerous out in space. The Cylons have taken over.
So is she in, like, that heavy, like, Star Trek makeup?
No. She's not Star Trek.
Whatever the fuck.
She wears, like, regular hot outfits. Yeah. Yeah. She's supposed to be seductive to humans.
Is she like the Jerry Ryan one?
No, she's much better looking.
Much better.
Is there any way this woman could steal your... steal your charms away from your wife?
Could she stop that marriage?
No woman could stop that marriage. Oh, here it is. No, Gilbert's DVD is $14.99 regular, right. $29.99 signed.
It goes way up.
That's 100, over 100%.
Yeah, it goes way up.
Yeah, it's worth it.
All right, they banned cigarette smoking in the workplace.
That's why I don't like the workplace.
They've banned cigarette smoking in restaurants.
Mm-hmm. Now they're going to ban it outdoors.
Some people are moving to ban it in other... And in Bangor, Maine, mm-hmm. you now cannot smoke when you're driving in your car with your kids.
Right, or be in your house with your kids.
Anywhere with your kids, but even in the car. You can get a fine. A police officer can stop you and fine you. In Bangor, Maine, you can get up to a $50 fine if you're caught smoking in your car when your kids are in the car with you.
What if you feed your kids McDonald's? That's unhealthy for them. Is that wrong? Arrest you for that?
No, they're only after the cigarette makers right now.
All right.
Here's a Bangor, Maine resident who agrees with the no smoking in cars for kids. Number 8.
I absolutely agree with that. No one should light up and let them breathe that smoke in.
I agree as well. I have to tell you that in the case of cigarette smoke, a little kid does not have a choice to leave the room.
And they could be absolutely engulfed in cigarette smoking all day if their parents smoke.
I think we're going too far with it. That's bullshit. I mean, it's my kid. He's in my house. I'm paying for him to sleep here. I might have a cigarette. Look, McDonald's will kill him quicker. I mean, it's. I mean, look, you want to go out?
But at least they have to go out to get the McDonald's. They're sitting at home and you're smoking?
Yeah, but the basis of this is, look, you can't do anything unhealthy to a kid. It's retarded.
I understand. You have to be able to do unhealthy things to your kid is your point, huh?
Well, no.
He's fighting.
I'm saying if you're going to do it all the way. What are we doing here? No mayonnaise.
No. Listen. Secondhand smoke is proven to kill you. Yes, you're right. Mayonnaise will kill you. Hamburgers will kill you.
When was the last funeral you went to? Someone died of secondhand smoke.
We don't know. We don't know. There are people who get lung cancer who never smoke.
We know.
We know there are people.
You don't believe what they're saying.
No one's ever died from secondhand smoke.
There are people who got lung cancer and they don't smoke.
Did you ever hear that commercial where the guy says his wife is dead? She never smoked. He was the smoker in the family.
Well, she had an unlucky gene or some shit.
She had lung cancer.
So that means you should smoke because you'll live longer.
I think everybody's different. Like, what? Yeah.
Here's my point. I'm for individual freedom. Don't get me wrong. I think you should be allowed to do what you want in your house. In the case of when you have kids and you're sitting and blowing smoke into their faces, it really is an offensive thing. The kid doesn't know any better, and they're sitting there and breathing in something that could potentially produce cancer. Now, I know what you're saying. How far are they going to take it? Are we going to see a day where people like drunk driving? Will we treat smoking the same way? Will somebody say, "Hey, you smoked in front of your kid. You're going to do jail time"? Now, will that happen? It seems crazy now, but it could happen. Now, but at the same point, if you're going to ask me my opinion, I've got to go on this side that people who smoke should have enough common sense not to smoke in the same room with their kids, but they don't.
Well, I mean, you talk about blowing it in their face. I'm talking about, you know, in the house, you have a cigarette.
No, look,
I think I should have the right, if I have kids, to give them cancer.
Is that me or is it
the right, Artie?
Yeah, I think if I'm paying for the rent on that house, if my kids get cancer, exactly. I should have the right to give that cancer to those kids.
Gilbert, will you smoke in front of your child?
Gilbert's encouraging his wife to smoke.
Well,
yes, Ralph.
You can't think that in a car, which is a small enclosed area, that you're not overdosing your kids with nicotine.
You absolutely are. Yeah. Ralph, go ahead.
My car.
Hey, now, I got a quick question for you. A couple days ago, you were talking about how you wanted to, like, do, like, bend Beth over and do her from the back there.
Yes.
Was that because on Battlestar Galactica, there was a scene when Baltar was, you know, the hot Cylon chick you were just talking about, and he had her bent over and he was doing her?
Well, there is, you're absolutely there, but that's always been a thing with me. I like going
but
into
it,
my...
It did sort of click a thing with you, right?
That's no, not at all. I do that all the time. I always want that.
She was hot, man, with her fucking ass sticking out.
Yeah. She's a hot chick. I just saw the Playboy pictures. Those are hot, right, Artie?
Smoking hot.
Yeah, okay.
Did you have a little bit of a butter face, though?
That's what I think.
I don't think so.
Right?
No, I haven't seen her face yet. Wait.
I think the face is a little busted.
A little bit. Season two, it kind of got a little shaky.
Busted?
Busted.
Yeah,
not according to these pictures.
Those are still pictures. I'm talking about a moving image.
Yeah,
well, you guys.
Hits it the wrong way.
You guys are tough.
Later on tonight, when I'm cutting out a hole in her mouth to fuck
her. If her face is busted, then
it's
what about
busted.
Me and Gilbert? I mean, what are we doing?
I'm a piece of ass.
Gilbert's a little quiet today. It's like a different Gilbert.
Well,
Gilbert,
if you talk about the wedding and
let
stuff
me tell
like
you
that,
something.
He's all freaked.
I am never bringing up the baby or the wife again because he's very depressed. During the commercials, I went over. I'm not going to say what I said to Gilbert.
Oh,
but
did you have a personal moment?
I have personal moments. I've never seen a guy.
Which is the most uncomfortable thing.
Yeah, oh, I witnessed that. Howard's talking to him. Gilbert's just looking at him like, yeah.
Gilbert's in a special coma all of a sudden.
You know, two words will get him out of it. Nigger tits.
That works for everybody.
Well, that ain't funny. All right, let's go. Robin, yes.
It's kind of funny.
Well, I don't like that. Go ahead, yes.
I'm telling a story of a guy who's clearly a racist.
Hey, take it easy.
Right? All the guy was a racist.
That was out
You're
of
making
context.
A point.
And out of context.
He paid an extra $50 to
Nobody remembers an hour ago. Go ahead.
Yeah.
I think our audience.
It's 11:07. Let Robin get to the news for good.
Yeah, I got to get to the wrap-up show. Come on.
We talked about this earlier. The Apple Corporation has come out with a new phone. It's to compete, I suppose, with the Blackberries and the Treos of the world. And it has a completely automated touch screen format. Here's Steve
But the Treo has that.
Gilbert, what's another way to say Blackberry?
No, I don't want to hear it. Please let me get done.
Encourage him. He's sitting over there sleeping. Leave him alone. Trying to get some rest.
I remember Gilbert from the Hollywood Squares a few years ago, and it made me laugh.
Apple.
African-American.
There you go.
Steve Jobs.
Hollyberry.
This is a phone he'd like to have.
Fred Rerum.
One of the big motivating factors for us is just creating something that we all want ourselves, too.
Jeez, well, thank you for laughing and cackling all over that.
Reading about the new phone.
Wheezy Berry.
Reading about the new phone that Steve Jobs and Apple are coming out with. I don't see anything all that new, but what do I know?
It's a little bit
That's on the Nipsey Russell Berry.
My Treo has a touch screen.
I'm going to ignore this.
My Treo has a touch screen.
The Slappy White Berry.
They're like the bad kids in class.
Yeah. They're screen.
The teacher's trying to go
on. The Scoey Mitchell Berry.
Get more obscure, why don't you?
Gilbert would watch TV once
Scully
in a while.
Scully Mitchell.
the watermelon eating berry.
All right, let's go, Robin. What else
enough,
you got to do?
Benji. Yeah. That was an awful joke.
The president will be speaking later today. He's finally ready to unveil his new plans for
the
Iraq.
The Cambridge berry.
Turn off his mic. Go ahead.
The lazy berry.
Oh, funny.
Oh, that's
already.
Funny. Come on, let's go.
Here's Tony Snow, who says that the president is changing Iraq's plans, but It won't end the debate, so don't expect all the talk about Iraq to go away. Number one.
The address the president is going to give to the nation is not the end of the debate. It is the beginning of an important consideration of how we move forward in Iraq.
Please, we have a
He's going to propose bringing in 20 to 30,000 more troops in order to quell, most of them in Baghdad, in order to quell the sectarian violence that's going on there and shore up the Iraqi government so that maybe they could start running things themselves. Here's Senator Harry Reid. He says the GOP will join Democrats in fighting an escalation in this war.
We believe that there's number of Republicans who will join with us to say no to escalation.
Senator Ted Kennedy also at the forefront of that fight. He says Congress must stop Iraq's escalation.
No additional troops can be sent and no additional dollars can be spent on such an escalation unless and until Congress approves the president's plan.
I sent you an email on my colored beret.
Oh, jeez.
I will send you a message on my Yaphet Kodo beret.
My James Baldwin beret.
My James Earl Jones beret.
Also, we must destroy any children of Gilbert Gottfried.
Yeah.
Anything else, Robin?
And let's make sure that Artie never has any.
Right, fine.
My black honeymooners beret.
My Cedric the Entertainer beret.
Marilyn Manson already has a new girlfriend, according to some accounts.
He's hot.
They say that Dita Von Teese, his wife, who has left him left over 2 weeks ago.
I'd like to drown that bitch.
Because of Marilyn's partying, but also because of his women friends. They say he was even friends with Angelina Jolie.
My brother killed Marilyn Manson.
Started adopting.
I'd like to drown her and then have a stingray sting her.
Yeah. She was a lot more fun.
My brother fucked Marilyn Manson.
Oh, Jesus.
Isn't that Marilyn Monroe, Mr.
Oh, I'm
President?
I'm sorry. My one brother fucked her. My other one killed her.
I was like, what? Anyway.
Our family works together.
Yeah.
They say that he's also been hanging around and gets constant phone calls from Lindsay Lohan.
Yes.
Marilyn, very popular with the young girls.
I tell you.
I knew Martin Luther King Berry.
And they also say now he's dating a young 19-year-old girl who he's doing a movie with.
So why does he get married? Why did
my George Kirby Berry.
Why did Marilyn Manson get married?
My Rochester
Berry. You're asking me this in a house of bedlam? Why?
You know what, Gary? Book Marilyn Manson. I want to ask him why he got married if he's taking calls from all these women.
I want to see what it was like. Blowing
he says,
my brother.
Everybody does it. Even Gilbert's getting married.
I drowned her 12 hours later. I emailed her on my Esther Old Berry.
Oh, jeez.
Anything else from?
My Amos and Andy Berry.
Wow. I'm glad you two are entertaining each other.
Because Rob called up and said Gilbert was quiet. Now it threw Gilbert into a tizzy.
My, what's that on
There's
Ralph's face, Berry?
Shut up.
My Sidney Poitier Berry.
If you said. If you said my Marion Berry, it would have been at least smitty.
That's something.
Well, no. I started with Holly Berry. That's
all
how it
right,
started.
Right.
Well, you went one too many.
Then
okay.
I went to Fred Rerun Berry, which I thought was
yeah,
nice.
And then what happened?
And then Gilbert had to start with this bullshit.
Like, go ahead, Robin.
There's something we haven't discussed.
Marion Berry's a good one.
Yeah, but you didn't think of it.
You're right.
Go ahead. Chuck Berry.
You're too busy just laughing at each other.
Chuck Berry.
There's a South Dakota senator who had a stroke.
Yeah.
And he was a Democrat.
Right.
And that's why the Democrats are in charge of the Senate right now.
We're in charge.
But the guy stroked. He's still at home in the hospital.
I'm stroking it right now.
I should be in charge with my enormous red head.
He underwent emergency brain surgery back on December 13th.
What do I have in common with Lucille Ball? Redhead.
And so as if he can't continue to be a member of the Senate.
My brother loved redheads.
The governor of his state,
I fuck Desi Arnaz.
Is a Republican. and he would appoint a Republican senator, which would then make it a 50-50 split.
I love Dick Ted
Cheney
Kennedy.
Would be the tiebreaker in any deadlock in the Senate, which would once again swing the control of the Senate
swing
to Republicans.
About the ways.
Here's Ted Kennedy.
This is crucial stuff.
Battlestar Galactica.
He doesn't care. He's getting married.
Oh my God! Yes, let the whole world go to hell. But anyway, yeah,
I have sex with the figs.
What?
It's not even funny.
I don't know. Now it's
ridiculous. Now it's ridiculous.
So anyway,
you're just being silly.
The Democrats' hold of the Senate is a very, very fragile one because this guy's in the hospital. He's in fair condition. That means his vital signs like blood pressure and temperature are stable and within normal limits, but he could be, you know, in the hospital for months.
Wow.
And still hold the seat. So he's going to sit there in the hospital and continue to be a senator.
Wow.
I've been a senator for 80
years. I know,
it means
nothing with all that noise going on.
All right. Anything else, Robin?
Saddam Hussein's attorney says he doubled his treadmill workouts just before his execution so he wouldn't look bad.
Oh, how nice. What a sick man.
Good idea.
What a nut. Like, wouldn't you just, like, let it go at that point?
Who cares? He doubled up on the treadmill.
I got one of these rag magazines. You know who let it go? Cher. She got heavy. Doesn't care anymore. Like,
she looks like Chastity now?
Not that heavy, but she's fat.
And I certainly have let it go.
It's like if Cher doesn't care, who cares?
Well, you know? Cher's pretty old now.
So what does that mean?
Nobody else cares.
You get old and you can't hold on?
No, that means she was keeping it together because guys wanted her, but I guess nobody wants her now.
I guess she was keeping it together and no guys wanted her. And she said, what am I doing this for?
Meanwhile, you know, you talk about what has happened to Saddam Hussein's image since he was hanged. An impoverished village in eastern India wants to honor him with a statue. They've petitioned the Indian government to change the name of the town to Saddam Hussein Lahana following his recent execution. So there's a little Indian town. His reputation spreads. Then now in India, there's a little town that wants to name itself after Saddam Hussein.
Yeah, they love him
to
now.
To honor him.
Everybody loves him now. Yeah.
Well,
it's like Professor Backwards over there. Anything we think that we're doing that's going to work doesn't.
Welcome to Husseinville.
I know what we'll do. We'll just kill Saddam Hussein. They'll finally be on our side. We kill him and they love him. They love him even more.
Yeah, if you want to be really popular, let us kill you.
Anything else, Robin?
The stomach flu is taking hold of the nation. They say flu has arrived with a vengeance this winter.
By the way, a true fact is that Hussein, what is it called? Hussein, what are they going to name the town?
Lahana.
Lahana, after Saddam Hussein.
Mm-hmm.
It's 15 miles north of Hitlerburg. Hey-o.
The so-called
email someone on your Kurt Floodberry.
Makes the rounds every winter and is hitting much of the country hard this year. The Center for Disease Control and Prevention says that the leading cause of contagious gastroenteritis is the novovirus, which is capricious and is easily spread. Wasn't that what hit Will?
Ma, this is capricious.
And that's awfully capricious.
Had an accident all over himself. And we know that the number one movie at the box office this week was Night at the Museum. They now say that the movie
it's hilarious.
Is so popular. What's that?
That
shut Artie up.
That's it. I'll stop anything you say. I'll stop talking later.
Please. But anyway, they say that visits to the Museum of Natural History have increased as a result of the popularity of the movie.
Oh, is that good?
It looks hysterical.
Yeah, it does. Yeah. You know, it's it's
what movie?
Ben Stiller.
Night at the Museum, Ben Stiller.
You won't go see that, huh, Gilbert?
Yeah, but it's up between that and the Cedric the Entertainer movie.
Here's Ellen Futter.
I haven't seen enough movies where Ben Stiller does every hack comedy move on the planet.
Here's Ellen Futter, who talks about the boost at the of attendance at the Natural Museum.
We've had a 20% overall increase, and that represents around 50,000 more people at this time over this.
They're all cocky. You know what I mean? Like, you know, we've had a 50,000 increase. Like,
they were so right to make that movie.
Period since the movie opened.
Most important movie ever.
Oh, my goodness. Charnatimo.
Anything else?
There you go.
Natural history to block.
Come on. How many shows? How many shows of a guy doing Paul Lynde on air?
All right, thank you, Robin. Gilbert, thank you for laughing to the whole newscast.
Lock the car doors. We're driving through a Barry neighborhood.
See Gilbert Gottfried tomorrow night, 8 o'clock at Caroline's on Broadway in Manhattan. For reservations, call 212-757-4100. Purchase Gilbert's DVD, the DVD Dirty Jokes. Go
oh,
to...
none of the funny stuff Gilbert was just doing is on his DVD.
GilbertGottfried.com.
The signed one it is.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you for joining us. And I will now do, as an encore, a 1-800-MATTRESS commercial. Because people are screaming for it again. 1-800-MATTRES. That's right. That's the number to spell because you want a new mattress. And why don't you want a new mattress? After all, you know, 60% of our lives are spent in the bed. And you want a good night's sleep. 1-800-MATTRES. Helps you start the new year off right with a great night's sleep, and their highly trained sleep consultants will make it so easy for you to get a good night's sleep and order a mattress. They can get you the mattress within 2 hours. 2 hours, no waiting.
Two?
7 days a week, 24 hours a day. It's 1-800-MATTRES.
Oh, you can't think of any more Barry references?
1-800-MATTRES.
Leave out the last S. That stands for Sandy Alomar Berry.
1-800-MATTRESS.com. Call them today. Get in on the big after sale. And let me tell you something. You will get the bed of your dreams. It's waiting for you at 1-800-MATTRESS and 1-800-MATTRESS.com.
Leslie Uggams Berry.
Get ready for King Norris Friday, January 19th at the Cubby Bear, 1059 West Addison Street, Chicago, Illinois. Show starts at 8 p.m. Call 773-327-1662 for details. Artie Lang with Sal, Richard, Bob Levy, and the boys from Bubba the Love Sponge. March 23rd at the Lakeland Center, Lakeland, Florida. Beer League is a laugh-out-loud raunchy comedy co-written, produced, and starring the hilarious Artie Lang. The two-disc DVD features enough bonus footage to please the most dedicated fan, including never-before-seen backstage footage of Artie on the Best Damn Sports Show and the Jimmy Kimmel Show. Artie Lang's Beer League, available today wherever DVDs are rented or sold. See the Reverend Bob Levy Friday, January 12th at the Northeast Philly Comedy Cabaret. Call 215-676-JOKE. And Saturday, January 13th at the Comedy Cabaret in Doylestown, PA. Call 215-345-JOKE or go to RevBobLevy.com. Bob Levy, Sal, Richard, and more. Saturday, January 27th at the Majestic Theater, Detroit, Michigan. Go to www.ticketmaster.com. Bob Levy, Sal Shuley, and more. Saturday, March 3rd at Headliners Music Hall, Louisville, Kentucky. Call 502-584-8088 for tickets or visit headlinerslouisville.com. To book Benji and his Naked Lesbian Bachelor Party strippers and to see their new dirty interactive website, go to dialadancer.com or call 1-800-414-7808.
And the lottery, she thinks I'm great.